Lies down in the green pastures. He leads me beside. Grazie a tutti.
A lot of people are crying because
But I just want to remind each of us here that this moment is the most important for us. Because whenever you come for a fair mass, you have to think about your life. You have to think about what you're doing with your own life. Today, Teresa is giving us the occasion to reflect on our relationship with God and our relationship with our brothers and sisters.
And you make room for God in your heart,
and in your life, you have things to do. Especially when you are intending to share with Jesus Christ one day, He's seated, you have things to do. And what you need to do is what you have heard in this gospel. Sometimes people think, okay, I believe in God. And that's the most important. Yes, it's important. But that's not the most important. The most important is to fulfill the will of God. To keep the commandments of God in your heart and work on that. Your life has to match. Has to match with what God wants to do. And what you have heard in the past, based on what I have heard from the testimonies that I received from people, the result is this. And we have to be grateful for her. She gave her life, her whole life, to Jesus Christ. She saved her life, taking that she has a master who is Jesus Christ. And he gave everything that she has to seek to remain faithful to the Lord. Based on what I heard. And I'm so grateful that she did it. Because the day you will meet the Lord, He will question you about what you have done. With Him as your master, I mean your relationship with Him, and now your relationship with your brothers and sisters. I heard that Teresa, she was really generous. She doesn't know how to say no to people. It's tough for her to say no if it comes to share with people. If it comes to be with people, to support people, she doesn't know how to say no. That's what I heard about her. She is a believer, a true believer. And she gave her life to Jesus Christ. And if you give your life to Jesus Christ, what you're supposed to do is what we heard in the gospel. I was hungry, and you gave me food. I was in prison. You visited me. I was sick. You cared about me. If you want to share with Jesus Christ one day, it's either you need to do that. Because Jesus Christ will not judge you based on, I went to church. Lord, you know, I prayed for you. No. But based on what you have done to your brothers and sisters, He said, if you did it for them, then no doubt you have done it for me. So you need to serve Jesus Christ in your brothers and sisters. That's what we heard in the gospel. And today the question is this: what are you doing with your life today? You, my brother, you, my sister, what are you doing with your life? What is the quality of your relationship with your brothers and sisters? If in your heart you know that you're not doing it, you're not doing what you're supposed to do, as a Christian, as a believer, as someone who believes in God, if you think you're not doing it, the time is right now. For you to start doing this. The reason why I'm saying this is sometimes we think we have years ahead. We will live for following the evil one that will set up clearly. And we don't take about God that we need in our lives. If you get rid of God in your life on the last day, the day of judgment, you will not have response for Him when you will be questioned. Do not get rid of God. Rather, remain with God, the one who created you. It's a time for truth. It's a time to say the truth, to tell you what is right to do. Most of the time, my dear brothers and sisters, we don't have time. I don't even have time to pray. We don't have time to go to church. We don't have time to read the Bible, to read the Word of God. So God is not present in our lives. And we just follow Him the world. But you don't know what will happen tomorrow. Maybe today you're doing well. But tomorrow, you don't know what tomorrow will bring. So be ready to be. And give your life to the Lord. Remain faithful to your baptism and believe in God. Because for sure, one day you will leave this earth and you will meet God Himself face to face. But will you share the kingdom with Him? That's the question. Yes, if He did His will. Today, we are praying for the reason. Now, she doesn't have power. She cannot pray for herself now. Now, He has to respond to the question of the Lord. What have you done with your life? And you take a balance seriously. We have to take a balance seriously. What are we doing with our life today? I'm saying this because we need it, my dear brothers. This morning, let me tell you this. This morning, when I woke up, I prayed and I took my cell phone and someone sent me a text message. I said, Father, please, I want you to pray for my wife. For your wife. And I went. She is in the ICU right now, intubated. Really? But I spoke to her yesterday at 6 p.m. My dear brother and sister, that lady, we spoke yesterday together on through the phone. After 6 years, and this morning, she's already in the ICU. Can you believe that? That's the reality of human being. So be careful. Be careful with what you're doing with your life. Be careful. Be nice to people. Be kind to people. Listen to God. Accept the will of God in your life. Because your life does belong to you, and He can call you at any time. God can summon you at any time. So when you take a life, you have to wake up and take your life seriously. We take Teresa because she's a woman who gives us the opportunity today to listen to God once again. Maybe you will not have another occasion. So God is talking to you right now through the funeral of our church. Listen to Him. Welcome the will of God in your life. And follow Him. When you accept Jesus Christ in your life, and you take your life. The most important for us is over the land. But what we are seeing today is people are looking for power, money, glory. Yes, you are powerful. You are powerful. You got money. You have houses, cars, everything that you need. Yes. But that will never give you happiness. That can participate, but not the source of happiness. The source of peace is God Himself, not material things that we have. The glory that you are seeking will leave you one day. The glory that you are chasing will leave you one day. So what you need is God. God is the only one source of happiness and peace. You have, you say, I will say, you have a couple of years. You have a couple of years to stay on this earth. And it's almost gone. Can you believe that? Can you know that? Do you understand that? Because what we are seeing today is crazy. People don't want to see, to hear about Jesus Christ, about that, nothing. People are preventing people, the priests, the pastors, all those religious workers, to talk about that. They don't want to hear that. But the reality is, God is the one who created the world. And He has the last word, and He has power over everything. Even over your life, your lost life. And your life will end at any moment. You don't even know the day, the time. Only God knows it. So what are you doing with your life? That's the question today, my dear brothers and sisters. A lot of people are thinking that if they have money and everything, then they can live forever. People are thinking that once you have money, it's okay. Money is God. Money will never be your God. I'm telling you. Money will never be your God. God is not the one who is everything. And we belong to Him. You belong to God. Do not let yourself be possessed by money or the evil one. But give your life to Jesus. The one who is saving you one day. The one who will welcome you in His kingdom. Fear Him and do good to people. Do not give hatred in your heart. Take your Bible. A lot of people today are still doing that. They are working for the evil one. Do not work for the evil one. Rather, work for God Himself. One day, He will take you. One day, He will welcome you in His kingdom. So it's a time for us, my dear brothers and sisters, to take seriously this reality. Human being is dying. You are dying. Today you say, me, know me, do you know me? You nothing, you nothing. My brother, my sister, you are nothing. You are nothing. Think about it. Think about it. And be willing to forgive your brothers and sisters. Because one day, you will need the forgiveness of God. And God says, if you do not forgive your brothers and sisters, your heavenly Father will not forgive you. Take a bow also. Because today people, they are not hurting their hearts. Betraying their brothers and sisters. Being mean to their brothers and sisters. Destroying lives. Do not be part of it. Stay away. I'm so grateful for her life. So grateful for her life. Based on what I've heard, she suffered a lot. She fought to have what she needs to take care of her daughter. And now today, she can go in peace and meet her Redeemer face to face with her fear, because she gave her life to him. What about you, my brother? What about you, my sister? Are you willing to give your life to Jesus Christ? Are you willing to accept God in your life? Are you willing to fulfill the will of God? Or you want to remain on this earth like that? And one day, God will call you. He will call you. And when you be before God, what will you say? When I see people saying, forget about it, God will say, God doesn't exist. The one who is saying that, wait a minute. One thing, he wants his secret, and they don't have a solution. For him, the doctors are saying, we don't know what's going on. Now everything is in the hands of God. We cannot get it. For him, once you know that, you will see him. Go and say, are you ready? Can I pray for you? He will say yes. But he used to say, forget about that. God is saying, God is, doesn't exist. Yes, when it comes to death, we are afraid. Everybody is afraid. I don't want to die. You don't want to die. What will we do? That's for sure. Now make sure that you will die at the right moment. And then when you meet your Creator, He will welcome you in His kingdom. That's the one you need to keep in your mind and in your heart. Today is a great day. You are trying your best. That's right. Because we love her. That is the reason why we are crying. But she's giving you the occasion to take your life seriously. Just listen to her. She's not talking, but her life is talking to you. This occasion is talking to you. This celebration is talking to you. My brother, my sister, will you listen to God? Yes, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples and said, "Take it, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. This is memory of me." Be pleased confirming faith and sharing your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Nelson, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people who have been for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Teresa, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh of those who have died, and transform our glorious body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are present to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, where we will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, mighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
As the Saviour's command and followed by divine teaching, we dare to say, our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of your Lord, now and
forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not at sins, but at the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. My dear brothers and sisters, let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace.
Thank you. Thank you for that song. It was the Lord of the Rings of the Dead. And I thank anyone for being here today to commemorate our beloved grandmother, to visit H.R. I'll give you a good gift to help you out. To visit H.R. to the second daughter of Mr. Matthew and Mrs. Youngwood Charles, she is one of the mom, Sylvia. She's completed her primary education in Bunk before furthering her studies at the Edmund Teachers Training College. After completing her studies at the Teachers College, she pursued additional education, receiving her secretarial certification. Her skills led her to employment in the civil services of the government of Sylvia, where she served in various functions. Teresa, or Grandma, as we know, she was definitely known for her vibrant personality. Later, she immigrated to the U.S. in the 70s, and she went to Michigan, where she devoted many years of her life working at Ford Motor Company. She also used to love to drive, and of course, she always drove before, at least anytime I saw her. She also loved her from her friends and her family. She loved her job, and of course, she loved her grandchildren, as she used to spend summers all the time in Detroit, Michigan with her. Teresa also loved to make jokes and laugh and was a free-spirited individual. Anyone that knows her definitely knows that. She loved to shop, she was very outgoing, and she always did her best. I remember when she used to come for a vacation and she used to have whole boxes of suitcases, barely any clothes for herself. She would bring them all to us when she came to visit. After she retired, she moved to Pennsylvania to be closer to her daughter, Margaret Tucker, and her grandchildren. She was a dedicated worker and devoted mother. Her warm and loving presence made her a cherished gem within our family. She had a passion for travel and treasured every moment spent with her loved ones. Grandma embraced her life with a fearless attitude and it is what it is outlook. She remained inherently kind-hearted. She forged a path, prioritized a stress-free existence on her own terms. She lived lively, thriving her sense of humor, and uses every moment with laughter through her witty jokes. She also loved her culinary explanations. She would like to, as my brother would know, we would go out and have our food. She would just say, get anything you want, and we would enjoy having our time with her. May her memory serve as a beacon of joy and laughter for all who were touched by her presence. She really enjoyed hosting us in the summer, and those were so much golden memories that we had. Again, thank you to all those that know Grandma. They know that she loves her humorous personality. She's also a very caring person. And we love her, our beloved grandmother, and her soul rest in peace.
Oh, who have been so tremendous and so good to us, you know. If you have like weddings, funeral, you can contact, her name is Nelly, and then our organist pianist is Gibson, okay? This is a community, Catholic community of mixing of all over Africa. It's not only West Africa, but Africa as a whole. And in the Catholic Church, we in the Archdiocese, we have Namibia, Sierra Leone, Guinea, Nigeria, Togo, and so many, you name it. But one thing about us Africans, we are not patronizing ourselves. I know that there are so many Catholics in Philadelphia region as a whole, but some of them have left the mother church and joined other churches. It is okay, but please, we are asking you guys to come back to your mother church so that we can move the gospel. You know, as Father has said, we have to be nice to each other. And in the Archdiocese, we always have like Catholic heritage, African heritage. You know, try to see where you belong. Put yourself somewhere. You know, not only going to church, meaning that you are a Christian, but get involved in the Catholic activities or whatever church you are in. Make yourself known. Take part in it, you know. So I thank you all for coming here today. And we are going to listen to Nelly. She's going to talk to you about this group.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you for coming and thank you for giving us the honor to sing at this ceremony. Our group is called Lux Ardenti. It means burning light, and it's a group of four. But unfortunately, we just have our first concert, and we live in different states. So I'm the only one here with the organist. But we do come together for special events, baptismal, like joyful event, not just funeral. So if you would like us to be there, please invite us. We just travel out of state. And at the end, you can come to me and I'll give you our contact point so you can solicit us. Thank you so much. Yeah, we do sing all kind of songs, like any languages. You have it, we'll learn it, we'll sing it. Thank you.
Happy. Guys, today, can you receive us a little of that for Father this person's
appreciate you, and we know that when I
my dear brothers and sisters, before the final examination, once again, I want to express on behalf of the pastor, Monsignor Victor, Father David, myself, our condolences to the whole family. I want to thank you all who are here today. And especially, I want to express my gratitude to Fatima. She did a lot. She did a lot. And the way she took this funeral for me is the expression of love for the deceased person and for the whole family. So, from what she has done, we can guess very easily that she truly loves the world. God and the family. May God bless you, and may He give you everything that you need from Him. Okay? So thank you for everything that you have done for the family. Before we go to our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister. May our God express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again, when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death.
Towards us and listen to our prayer. Open the gates of paradise. Father, we come for you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Our sister Teresa has gone to her rest in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome her to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope in eternal life, let us assist her with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with our sister. Together, may we meet Christ Jesus when he who is our life appears in glory. This is the will of my Father, says the Lord, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, and that I should raise it up on the last day. Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you hallowed the graves of all who believe in you, and so made the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our sister may sleep here in peace until you awaken her to glory, for you are the resurrection and the life. Then she will see you face to face, and in your light will see light and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Because God has chosen to call our sister Teresa from this life to himself, we commit her body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for his reason, the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise up her body on the last day. Our sister Teresa, we are praying for her. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me shall live even in death, and whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Teresa and dry the tears of those who weep. We pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
You raised the dead to life. Give to our sister eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
You promised paradise to the repentant sinner. Bring the result to the joys of heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, yes.
She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, yes.
Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of Teresa. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear.
God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant Teresa. Do not count her deeds against her, for in her heart she desired to do your will. as her faith united her to your people on earth, so may your mercy join her to the angels in heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now we bow down. Merciful Lord, you know the anguish of the sorrowful. You are attentive to the prayers of the humble. Hear your people who cry out to you in their need and strengthen their hope in your lasting goodness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Eternal rest grant unto her, O Lord. The Lord be with you.
With you.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Family, the flower that you hold is a symbolic token of this here, your loved one. We ask that clergy deposit their flowers first. Immediately after clergy, we ask that those that served as pallbearers to come and deposit their flowers.
Praise the name of
Jesus.
Lord, and let our deeds follow you.
Family, on behalf of the funeral home, the Exodus Funeral Chapel, we would like to thank you for allowing us to serve you on this here, your most difficult hour. Hopefully something we said or done has surely been a source of comfort to you all. If so, our aim has been accomplished. This now concludes the services for our dear loved one. You may now go in peace. Just remove all funeral stickers from your window and obey all Philadelphia rules and traffic regulations. God bless you. And the family is inviting you all back to have fellowship with them back at the repast at the Philly Inn on City Avenue. God bless you all.
Mommy! 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 Don't leave me, Mommy! Mommy! Mommy!
Go that way.